Hello and welcome along. Today on Cobra Park Farm Ultimate Edition, we are going to be creating some hay. So we're going to cut this field. This is field 21 with our Blue Power New Holland and our Kuhn mowers. And then we're going to go around and tether it. And collect it up and have some hay. So then we should be able to feed the cows. So without further ado, let's get going. Start up our tractor. We'll stay off the muddy track for the most part. Fold out our mowers. Turn them on. Turn them on. Drop them down. And drop them down. Oop. Okay. Drop both sets down at once. There we go. And away we go. I'm quite glad this tractor can handle this. This is not a very big field. We should get this done this episode, even though we have lots to do on it. We do need to bale it, and so we need to tether it. I am forgetting one stage of this. But we're basically going to... we tether it, windrow it, and then bale it. So there's lots of tasks to do on it, but it's not a huge field, so we should do it quite quickly. And we don't need an awful lot of hay bales. We only need sort of one or two, so... Doing this on a small field will mean we should get it all done at once. Right, so we're not going to mow the muddy track. We are going a bit slower uphill. So I think once we get a couple of rounds done, we might want to start going up and down the field. Although it looks like the whole thing is a hill up to the side, so... or up to this corner. And at least going downhill like this, it speeds up quite a bit. Oh, we missed a bit on that corner. There's a proper dip in the corner of this. Moving up. That's up. There we go. Aha, great demand for pigs. Fortunately, we don't have any pigs. I think if I was doing a lot more episodes on this series, we would get the pigs and the beef. Fortunately, we are limited in our time. So we're only going to have our dairy cows and our chickens and our sheep on this map. We do need to go and move that wool pallet. Because our sheep aren't producing anymore while that wool pallet is full, so... going to make short, these butterfly mowers are going to make short work of this field. We'll have to come back and pick up those extra bits. So turn around up here. Oh,
climb that's a steep hill. It doesn't like that while it's running these rows. Okay, we've got what we were after. Would you use the follow me mod behind this? Who? Not overly playing ball. Alright, it's not wide enough actually, to be honest. Got some clearing up to go do on the side. We seem to always get a little bit off course down, going down that corner. So we'll go and pick up those tufts in a moment. We finish this bit. It's not even that steep a hill at the moment, but I think this running these mowers is probably at the high end of what this tractor can do. It's got 170 horsepower. Available to it. Going to tether with the T5, so I'm going to go and need to empty my combine in a bit, but we'll do that between mowing and getting the tether on it. If we get this whole thing in, no, we're not going to. Unfortunate as that is. There we go. Just use the front mower to finish this off. we are. So, pick that up. Back to the yard. And keep our tractor a little bit clean. We've just had it washed after all the work it did with the sprayer. Right, so we shall park this up in here. Out of the way. And just hop over to this and see if we can find our combine in the midst. I'm guessing it's down the bottom end of the field somewhere. There it is. So we're still doing our wheat harvest with the combine. We've still got a lot of harvest to get in. There we go. So we'll leave that doing that. And hop out of our T7 and into our T5. Start that up. And reverse up. Now what I am going to do is just quickly pop out here and move this pile of wool, which we can do with the header on the back. On and pick up our forks. Two jobs at once. There we go. Oh. I seem to have got stuck on the. Looking back a bit. Okay. That may not help us. Yeah, there we go. Hopefully it has. Right, so we're just going to move this wool out of the way so that our sheep can start producing that again. Oh, we got the auto load on. Never mind. I'll just put that out of the way on the other side. I'm not moving. There we go. There we go. Right, so then we can just take the whole front assembly off. There we go. Right, let's go tether our field. I do like the addition of these tracks through here. It makes a little bit more sense to me. With the setup. And you would have muddy tracks through fields if you were driving through here all the time. So that does make sense to me. And away we go. Right, let's tether this field quickly. Now our baler is back at the main farm, ready to do field 6, which I haven't baled yet. So I'm gonna have to go and get that in a bit. We may do the windrowing and the tethering next the windrowing and the baling next episode, simply because that then leaves us our last 2 episodes, hopefully to do some potato harvesting. This is what I want to get. Ultimately, that is our goal for our last 2 episodes. So, in the meantime, we are doing this to try and get some money off the cows, because I would like to take some milk in to sell it. We have the no milk sale mod active here, so we have to take the milk in ourselves. As a result, once we get our cows' productivity up, that will help them a lot. This tractor can easily handle this this job, which is great. Part of the reason we have the little T5 about is to handle as much of the animal stuff as we can. Not really used our other little tractor, the 6640, I think it is, we've got up at the other yard. Has for the most part done the job that we've been after. We have done a little bit of carting corn up for our chickens with it. Not much else really. Go round, I think, on this one. So take a wide circle. Right, so clean that up a bit. Because I've got enough space, I'm just gonna go and do this little bit. Come back in on this corner and clean this up. Right, so tidy up the edges a little bit so it makes it easier for us to finish the field off. There we go. Swap machines quickly and get the windrower on here, and that will get this all windrowed up quite nicely. Ready for us to get the baler on it next episode, I think. And we can bale it and collect it up. It won't be a lot of, I don't think we'll get that many. I don't think we'll get that many bales off here. Maybe 5 or 6. Look at the size of the peel. It will be enough to do what we want to do. One more. There we go. And all done. So we will head back to the barn. Switch over to the windrow, which this tractor should also be able to do. That will then set us up to get it all baled. Yeah, so that sign there, that is the no milk. No milk sale. And we do it ourselves. Disconnect the PTO, disconnect the tether. And connect up to our windrower. There we are. Oh, and jumps into the wrong tractor. There we go. Alright, let's get this working. Tether up our hay. Nope, it's not. Try and keep everything in. Oop, a little close to the edge. Up. I'm not a great fan of doing this first one. Can always get a little bit close into the hedgerow. And the keyboard steer is a little bit too. It's either all or nothing, pretty much. Part of the reason why I'd love to have a steering wheel.
some ground in.
Pick up some of the first round while we're doing it. Okay. Seems to happen a little bit. Should get a nice amount of bales off this. So don't need a huge amount, just need enough to do what we want to do, which is feed our cattle. Would actually give us enough to get some beef and some pigs, actually. Which I don't think we've earned enough money to get beef and pigs. Start going up and down. That way. That might leave us a couple of little spots that we have to pick up with the baler later. Nicely rowed up. There is a solution to that, which is basically this. Just go around quickly and collect up all the ends. Just tidy it up so it's easier for our baler to pick up. Go and return this into our shed. can't get this in here straight. There we go.
That's where we'll end, I think. So, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like and drop us a comment. And for all the latest videos from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.